As we look toward the future of farming, we can't help but wonder, what will the fields of tomorrow look like? Join us as we explore the cutting-edge technologies that are revolutionizing agriculture, from the skies with drones to the ground with robots, and the precision that comes with advanced data analytics. Get ready to witness how these innovations are transforming the world of farming as we know it. Welcome to another incredible agriculture video. In today's video, we will discuss the future of agriculture, so make sure you stick till the end. Today's agriculture has transformed into a high-tech enterprise that most 20th century farmers might barely recognize. After all, it was only around 100 years ago that farming in the U.S. transitioned from animal power to combustion engines. Over the past 20 years, global positioning systems, GPS, electronic sensors, and other new tools have moved farming even further into a technological wonderland. Beyond the now de rigueur air conditioning and stereo system, a modern large tractor's enclosed cabin includes computer displays indicating machine performance, field position, and operating characteristics of attached machinery like seed planters. And as amazing as today's technologies are, they're just the beginning. Self-driving machinery and flying robots able to automatically survey and treat crops will become commonplace on farms that practice what has come to be called precision agriculture. The ultimate purpose of all this high-tech gadgetry is optimization, from both an economic and an environmental standpoint. We only want to apply the optimal amount of any input, water, fertilizer, pesticide, fuel, labor, when and where it's needed to efficiently produce high crop yields. Drones have the potential to revolutionize farming in a number of ways. Precision agriculture. Drones equipped with sensors and cameras can collect high-resolution data on crops, soil, and weather conditions, enabling farmers to make more informed decisions about when to plant, water, and harvest crops. This can lead to more efficient use of resources, higher yields, and better quality produce. Crop monitoring. Drones can be used to monitor crops for signs of disease, pests, or other problems. This can allow farmers to take action before problems spread and damage their crops. Crop spraying. Drones equipped with sprayers can apply pesticides or other chemicals to crops more precisely and efficiently than traditional methods. This can reduce waste and exposure to harmful chemicals. Mapping and surveying. Drones can be used to create detailed maps and 3D models of farms, which can be used to plan crop rotations, assess drainage, and identify areas that need improvement. Overall, drones have the potential to save farmers time and money, reduce the environmental impact of farming, and increase yields and quality of crops. As drone technology continues to evolve, it is likely that it will become an increasingly important tool in the future of farming. Global positioning gives hyperlocal info. GPS provides accurate location information at any point on or near the Earth's surface by calculating your distance from at least 3 orbiting satellites at once. Farming machines with GPS receivers are able to recognize their position within a farm field and adjust operations to maximize productivity or efficiency at that location. Take the example of soil fertility. The farmer uses a GPS receiver to locate preselected field positions to collect soil samples. Then a lab analyzes the samples and creates a fertility map in a geographic information system. That's essentially a computer database program adept at dealing with geographic data and mapping. Using the map, a farmer can then prescribe the amount of fertilizer for each field location that was sampled. Variable rate technology, or VRT for short, fertilizer applicators dispense just exactly the amount required across the field. This process is another example of precision agriculture mentioned earlier. We have already mentioned it twice, but what exactly does precision agriculture consist of? Info, analysis, tools. Precision agriculture requires 3 things to be successful. It needs site-specific information, which the soil fertility map satisfies. It requires the ability to understand and make decisions based on site-specific information. Decision-making is often aided by computer models that mathematically and statistically analyze relationships between variables like soil fertility and the yield of the crop. Finally, the farmer must have the physical tools to apply the management decisions. In the example, The GPS-enabled VRT fertilizer applicator serves this purpose by automatically adjusting its rate as appropriate for each field position. Other examples of precision agriculture involve varying the rate of planting seeds in the field according to soil type and using sensors to identify the presence of weeds, diseases, or insects so that pesticides can be applied only where needed. Site-specific information goes far beyond maps of soil conditions and yields to include even satellite pictures that can indicate crop health across the field. Such remotely sensed images are also commonly collected from aircrafts. Now, unmanned aerial vehicles, also known as UAVs or drones, can collect highly detailed images of crop and field characteristics. These images, whether analyzed visually or by computer, show differences in the amount of reflected light that can then be correlated to plant health or soil type, for example. Clear crop health differences in images, diseased areas appear much darker in this case, have been used to delineate the presence of cotton root rot, a devastating and persistent soil-borne fungal disease. Once disease extent is identified in a field, future treatments can be applied only where the disease exists. The advantages of UAVs include relatively low cost per flight and high image detail, but the legal framework for their use in agriculture remains under development. Automatic guidance, whereby a GPS-based system steers the tractor in a much more precise pattern than the driver is capable of, is a tremendous success story. Safety concerns currently limit the completely driverless capability to smaller machines. Fully autonomous or robotic field machines have begun to be employed in small-scale high-profit margin agriculture, such as wine grapes, nursery plants, and some fruits and vegetables. Autonomous machines can replace people performing tedious tasks, such as hand harvesting vegetables. They use sensor technologies, including machine vision, that can detect things like the location and size of stalks and leaves to inform their mechanical processes. Japan is a trend leader in this area. Typically, agriculture is performed on smaller fields and plots there, and the country is an innovator in robotics. Autonomous machines are becoming more evident in the U.S., particularly in California, where much of the country's specialty crops are grown. The development of flying robots gives rise to the possibility that most field crop scouting currently done by humans could be replaced by UAVs with machine vision and hand-like grippers. Many scouting tasks, such as for insect pests, require someone to walk to distant locations in a field, grasp plant leaves on representative plants, and turn them over to see the presence or absence of insects. Researchers are developing technologies to enable such flying robots to do this without human involvement. Breeding, sensors, and robots. High-throughput plant phenotyping is an up-and-coming precision agriculture technology at the intersection of genetics, sensors, and robotics. It is used to develop new varieties or lines of a crop to improve characteristics such as nutritive content and drought and pest tolerance. HEPP employs multiple sensors to measure important physical characteristics of plants, such as height, leaf number, size, shape, angle, color, wilting, stalk thickness, the number of fruiting positions. These are examples of phenotypic traits, the physical expression of what a plant's genes code for. Scientists can compare these measurements to already known genetic markers for a particular plant variety. The sensor combinations can very quickly measure phenotypic traits on thousands of plants on a regular basis, enabling breeders and geneticists to decide which varieties to include or exclude in further testing, tremendously speeding up further research to improve crops. Agricultural production has come so far in even the past couple of decades that it's hard to imagine what it will look like in a few more. But the pace of high-tech innovations in agriculture is only increasing. Don't be surprised if, 10 years from now, you drive down a rural highway and see a very small helicopter flying over a field, stopping to descend into the crops, using robotic grippers to manipulate leaves, cameras, and machine vision to look for insects, and then rise back above the crop canopy and head toward its next scouting location, all with nary a human being in sight. The Artificial Intelligence Institute for Resilient Agriculture at Iowa State University is one of four groups building that proverbial sink with what it calls ultra-precision agriculture. The institute hopes to, over the next 3 to 5 years, use data science, machine learning, and other artificial intelligence technologies to provide corn and soybean growers with personalized recommendations that will boost crop production. The tools also could help industry scientists develop seeds that deliver higher yields while resisting drought and other stressors. This will become increasingly important as drought and desertification shrink the world's acreage per capita of arable land, and the world's population balloons to 9.7 billion by 2050. As researchers look to artificial intelligence, drones, and robotics to help agronomists prepare for this future, industry analysts expect the global market for precision agriculture, valued at $4.84 billion in 2018, to reach $10.16 billion within the next 2 years. One common concern raised in any discussion of artificial intelligence is the loss of jobs to machines and robots. That may not be an issue in agriculture, where bringing advanced technologies to farm communities could offset a labor force that is shrinking as farmers retire and young people move away. Thank you for joining us on this journey into the future of farming, brought to you by the Incredible Agriculture Channel. We hope you found this video informative and thought-provoking. With the help of drones, robots, and precision agriculture, farmers have the tools they need to feed a growing population while minimizing their impact on the environment. As technology continues to advance, we can only imagine what other innovations will arise to help us meet the challenges of the future. Don't forget to like and subscribe for more content like this, and we'll see you in the next video. Let us know your thoughts down below. Is technology taking jobs away or creating more avenues for employment?